I'm Flora, and this is my Across RCA submission. For this video, I critically reflect on our project through responding to the Across RCA questions provided on Moodle, and finish with a short video to summarise our final project response. So why did you decide on the format and approach of your final team response? So our question that we decided for the brief of this project was, how can we illuminate methods of powers that women artists hold to ensure they are able to exercise their agency? Firstly, we decided to create a written manifesto. However, what we discovered by the second half of the project was that it would be better to create a more tangible and visual experience that would allow people to come into our space and our thinking to create an atmosphere of women's strength, unity, and promotion. So we designed and created the exhibition, I'm Not Cruel, Only Truthful, for the sole purpose to respond and answer our project brief. What ideas or artifacts informed your approach? So my project approach was shaped by the research I carried out. In the art world, societal expectations often hinder women's success. Gender roles and stereotypes limit their potential, discouraging them from entering the competitive scene, which is really sad if you think about it. Confidence is an important role to play, yet psychologically many women struggle with self-doubt more compared to men. So overcoming these barriers requires a societal shift, empowering women to embrace their creativity and challenge these norms. Celebrating successful women can also inspire others to take this step and foster a supportive environment to grow. We wanted to address these challenges, which are crucial for women to confidently pursue success. So our exhibition had the purpose to provide a platform where women's voices could be amplified to create a more inclusive artistic landscape that nurtures talent and breaks from societal constraints. Are there any particular features of your response that you wish to highlight, and why? Overall, our group came together and worked on this project really successfully. At the beginning, there were a couple ups and downs about understanding each other and bouncing smoothly along like our different time schedules. But I think one thing to highlight is that the five of us are from totally different worlds, from backgrounds, creative practices, ages, and we've all come together into this mutual ground of doing Across RCA and bringing our individual ideas. But by having this mutual commonality of being artists, women artists, we faced the same inequalities in the industry. So it was really exciting that we could actually respond and took a shared common likeness to bring together women from diverse backgrounds to create this exhibition and shine a light on their artistic achievements, which was really exciting. What is the value and or potential social impact of your team project? So through our projects, our aim has always been to inspire others, spark conversations, and promote positive change in how women are perceived and represented in the art community. And ultimately having the goal to contribute to a more inclusive and supportive environment where all artists, regardless of gender, can thrive and succeed. How did the response align with the proposal and feedback from part one of the unit? So our feedback primarily focused on two points. One being that manifestos in this subject area have already been done, so what makes ours unique? And secondly, how will our project be executed? So for the first semester, we were solely focusing on creating a written manifesto. We quickly realised with peer and mentor feedback that there may be more successful ways to achieve our goal for our project. So we created this exhibition as a response to the feedback, where this would allow our ideas to be promoted, seen, experienced in an atmosphere created to change and for impact. I also believe that sometimes when you write something, it doesn't always have that effect that an actual in-person experience has. So we managed to effectively respond to the feedback as a team, which was really exciting. So what do you consider the success in your team response, the successes in your team response, and what is less successful? So one significant success was our ability to come together, sharing ideas and experiences, which truly helped the process of accomplishing the exhibition. However, in hindsight, we recognised that we could have benefited from more in-person meetings, even though our reliance on online communication was practical, face-to-face interactions might have sped up the process and enhanced our communication further. Despite the challenges we had with our conflicting schedules, we adapted by maintaining regular communication through various channels such as regular calls, emails, shared documents and group chats. This allowed us to be flexible and keep moving forward, ultimately being able to achieve our goals. It was a process to organise the exhibition, with a special shout out to Anna, because she maintained management successfully for the organisation of it. It involved months of planning, coordination, from securing the venue to organising guests, arranging resources and equipment. The positive feedback we received and successful completion of the event were immensely rewarding outcomes, I have to say, and I'm just thankful for the opportunity to have been part of it. During the process of putting the exhibition together, we encountered some conflicts of interest. However, as we improved our communication skills to each other, we were able to navigate through this and ultimately overcome these challenges, which was really good. So how did you critically engage with your peers, and how did you locate yourself in the project? Also, I'm joining this question with, how was the work divided amongst the team, and how did you collaborate collective thinking change? How did the collaborative collective thinking change the approach? So throughout our project, we engaged in collaborative research and decision making. We gathered individual research contributions, evaluated them as a group, and identified key focus areas, critically analysing different viewpoints as a collective. For instance, Anna's discovery about the dominance of male artists in art sales fueled our thematic exploration for the whole project, so that was pretty good to start the project off with. We progressed from secondary to primary research by designing and distributing surveys to diverse artists. So we'd send out like amongst all of our peers and artists that we know. And I analysed these responses and developed the foundation of our sort of manifesto that we kind of created as a guideline for our exhibition's direction. My role included idea mapping, coordinating research, writing analysis statements, and contributing photography and videography. I personally felt that we worked pretty collectively, and with each member taking on tasks that suited their specific strengths. Overall, working collaboratively inevitably comes with its issues, whether it's difference of interest, perception, or like your communication. Fortunately, our group was prepared to overcome these barriers and learn from them effectively to progress efficiently during the last 6 months of this project. What wider networks were you exposed to, and how did this inform your response? Throughout the project, we were fortunate to connect with a wide array of networks, from artists and academic professionals to the guests who attended our show, and also the university's resource team. With each interaction was really informative, and it was really nice to like meet a whole like array of different people. The feedback and perspectives shared by guests were invaluable as well, because their presence helped us refine our exhibition's like impact and relevance, ensuring that our message resonated with our audience. Our engagement with fellow artists and academic professionals was really useful as well. Through surveys and discussions that I mentioned before, we gained insights into various perspectives within the art and academic community. So that was really nice, and just like to meet the range of artists and like women in the community. These interactions not only informed our conceptual focus, but also guided our decision-making process, which was pretty helpful, contributing significantly to the success of the exhibition. And final question, how will you take this experience forward into your practice and research? I've developed a profound understanding of the challenges faced by women in the art world just from this project, particularly as a future fashion designer, hopefully. The insights gained from this experience have been truly enlightening and impactful. They have broadened my perspective on navigating like the industry, and empowered me to confront issues of inequality in art sales as I embark on my journey post-graduation. So yeah, I feel like it's definitely going to take me on this journey of trying to be confident and create space within the industry. Thank you so much for listening.
Centuries. Mm-hmm. Women have been undervalued mm-hmm. for a long, long time, and it's still happening today.
here's an opportunity to be free and just to let yourself live and be who you actually are.